You want to play Magic Legends in open beta but are not sure which Planeswalker class to pick for your first playthrough? In this video I will go over all the abilities and Planeswalkers and hopefully help you decide. Hey guys, my name is Jan and I'm a big Magic the Gathering fan. I usually post Magic the Gathering content, but I'm also very excited for the Magic Legends open beta. So I decided to make a video and help you guys decide which Planeswalker class to pick on Tuesday. I will give you a quick overview of the abilities of all Planeswalkers and if you're not a Magic the Gathering player, also give you a feel for the colors represented in this game and by the Planeswalkers. There are 5 Planeswalker classes to choose from in open beta. The Sanctifier, the Mind Mage, Necromancer, Geomancer and the Beast Caller. Please note that I gathered all the information from streams and trailers available at the moment. Also note that you can play every Planeswalker in your playthrough and unlock them step by step. Also, every Planeswalker class can choose every color and play every deck in Magic Legends. You are not limited to the colors represented by your Planeswalker. The Sanctifier represents white mana and then Magic the Gathering that stands for life, holy clerics, knights, warriors, angels and all that good stuff. So in RPG sense this could maybe be a support class. We haven't seen all the cards in all decks so this is just speculation. Each Planeswalker class has 3 unique abilities to generate mana. The Sanctifier is more of a ranged class. Divine Bolt fires piercing bolts of holy energy at distant enemies. Wave of Radiance is probably an AoE attack and fires a wave and dealing holy damage to all enemies caught in the wave. Salvation generates a devotion counter and this means creatures you control are healed. The Mind Mage represents blue mana and in the Magic the Gathering universe this represents controlling your opponent on the battlefield. Apart from your mind control you summon wind and water creatures. And in the card game it is also possible to overcome your opponent without playing any creatures at all. Also like the Sanctifier this is a ranged class. You have energy orbs hovering you and you can throw them at your enemies to deal damage. The second ability also is an AoE ability. You attack in a cone in front of you and confuse and stun your enemies not killed by this attack. The third ability is a taunt and escape and gains movement speed. So you hop into battle, get a reflection of yourself and with movement speed get out of harm's way. Black represents death and terror but also reanimation and life drain. You're probably summoning clerics, zombies, vampires, demons and other dark creatures. In Magic the Gathering and Magic Legends every class can summon creatures. So this might be a little bit confusing in sense to other RPGs where only the Necromancer can resummon enemies. But of course I would assume a lot of life drain, healing and resummoning of slaying foes will be with this class. The Necromancer seems to be a close combat class. The first Necromancer ability, slashing at your enemies in front of you and dealing damage over time. The second ability deals damage around you and already summons a skeleton. The third ability deals damage around you and heals you for damage dealt. Red mana and the Geomancer represents fire, rage. The red color is about dealing direct damage to your opponents and overcome your enemies with a large army of small creatures, like goblins for example, dealing fire damage, doing shields with the earth and blasting through your enemies. Like the Necromancer, this is also a close combat class, dealing damage with your fists. And this is also the first ability, dealing damage directly to your opponents with your fists. The second ability is a knockback with stone damage. And the third ability is an AoE and movement skill, so you can leap into action. The Beast Caller. Green mana represents nature, forest and big beasts to strike down your opponents. The Beast Caller wields an axe to strike down his enemies. It is also a close combat class and with green you can expect big creatures calling nature to overcome your foes and buffing your minions and companions. The first ability is Wind Slash and you cleave your opponents in front of you. The second ability is an axe throw ability that marks your enemies, probably to deal more damage in the next attacks. The third ability heals you and your companion over time and teleports the companion to you. Like I mentioned before, every class will be able to play every color represented in Magic Legends. You of course in the beginning will get a starter deck. Progressing through the game you will be able to play every color and combine up to 2 colors. In Magic the Gathering, every color can be combined with everything. Some may be synergized better with others, but every combination is possible. So it will depend on what cards you find and what artifacts you unlock and what playstyle is for you. Artifacts will probably heavily influence your game. Like this one, it buffs blue and black, so you will be more drawn to upgrading your blue and black cards. I hope with this short video I could help you decide which Plainswalker class to pick on Thursday when open beta hits. I would be very interested to know which class you will start with. Just tell me in the comments below. I will be posting more Magic Legends content once the beta is out, so consider following the channel for more content on Magic Legends. I hope you guys have fun in open beta, and I also hope to see you guys on the next video.